Fox 5 News.
Clark, we're live this morning in downtown Bethesda, where this weekend it will be turned into a speedway of sorts. Why? Because Team Snow Valley is in town, and they are gearing up for the third annual Team Snow Valley Grand Prix in Bethesda. I'm joining the team for today, at least. Coming up, though, we are going to give you a preview of the event and tell you why you might want to make it a part of your weekend plans. Look at them, up and riding already. It's all straight ahead on Fox 5 Morning News. Stay with us. I'll see you guys on.
Traffic of a different kind. 400 to 500 bicyclists will be racing through Bethesda, Maryland this Sunday in the third annual Snow Valley Bethesda Grand Prix of Cycling. Our Holly Morris is in the Woodmont area of Bethesda this morning to bring us a preview. Holly, I hope you stretched properly before getting on that bike.
Well, you know, funny that you mentioned that, because I didn't, and I'm having trouble walking now. But let me tell you this, Team Snow Valley, this is their biggest event that they organize each year. And if you come out this Sunday, you will see the top professional and amateurs that will be here racing. And you're going to have a lot of fun as well, because they have some good activities planned. Arch McCown is the president of the team, the race director. He's racing in the event, and he brought me this really cool jacket. So why don't you do something this morning?
That's right. Well, you're here to talk about the race, and I think it's going to be a really great day. Looks like the weather, according to you guys, is going to really be shaping up for us. It's a wonderful event because it treats the spectators to the flash of riders probably about every minute. Mm-hmm. It's a 1 kilometer closed course right through downtown Bethesda here on the Woodmont Triangle. So spectators will get to see the riders, you know, all day long, just going around and around and around.
So it'd be pretty fun.
Oh, yeah.
You have different categories of racing. So explain to me how that works, because someone that doesn't know much about bicycle racing, you know, when I think of that, I think, okay, Tour de France. So where are we in this grand spectrum of bike racing?
Right. Well, the Grand Prix is a pretty cool race because it has categories for everybody from beginners on up to pros. Mm-hmm. And so earlier in the day, we have the age-graded races, which are for the older men and women and the less experienced riders. And that's usually like a Category 4 type mm-hmm. rider, Category 5. And the scale goes from 5 being novice on up to 1 being like professional elite level. And towards the end of the day is the pro women's race and the pro men's race.
And our own Mike Landis will be the official starter for those races. Fox 5 is a co-sponsor of this event. Let me ask you this. You said there's not necessarily a novice, so it's not for beginners, but you are having a sprint race for kids. How can families get involved in that?
Well, basically they show up the day of at about 10 o'clock till 12 o'clock. We'll be registering the kids. So the parents just register the kids, and it's a 4-block long straight line sprint. Mm-hmm. And they get to come across the finish line in front of a couple thousand spectators. And, you know, last year we had over 100 children here, so it was a good, you know, it was a great day. Ronald McDonald's going to be there to start the kids.
How can you resist when Ronald himself shows up?
Yes, exactly. So it's great, great fun for everybody.
We have some other characters that have shown up here this morning, so I have to introduce my cyclists that are hard working out. I've got Josh Frick, Kim Bonacorsco, and Wally Bixby on the bike there on the end. I just can't resist Wally Bixby's name. I love that. Good morning, you guys. Thanks for coming out. I want to talk a little bit about getting to this level. How long have you been training, riding in order to become, and you're Category 1, correct?
Yeah. Actually, I moved up fairly rapidly through the ranks. I joined Snow Valley 2 years ago, and I'd been racing competitively a year before that. And, I graduated from college, quit my job, and I'm racing.
Riding ever since.
Racing now full time.
Wow, good luck. Good for you. Very fun. Kim, tell me what it's like to be in the heat of battle. You're in there racing. I mean, pretty exciting?
Oh, it's definitely an adrenaline rush. You know, that's why I do it. I love the speed. I love the tactics involved. People really don't realize the amount of tactics involved in bike racing. Mm-hmm. They kind of think it's like a marathon. You just go out there and go as hard as you can, but you have teammates that, you know, go to the front of the pack and block, and there's, you know, breakaways or sprint, field sprinting where you're elbow to elbow, you know, going for the line.
Wally, I only have about 30 seconds left, but I want you to give me your best pitch why you think people should get involved in this sport.
It's a great way to stay healthy. It's good fun. You get to see the outdoors a lot. You get to travel. You can go places, and anywhere you go, whether America or Europe, you can ride your bike to get around.
And you can go nowhere fast. That's what's great about these machines. They're just riding, and they're staying in place. Hey, listen, you can come out and see them actually ride the course, though, this weekend. It is the Snow Valley Bethesda Grand Prix of Cycling this Sunday from 9 a.m. until 4:30 in the Woodmont area of Bethesda. It's a day-long event. Of course, you can eat at many of the wonderful restaurants in this area as well. They're going to have live music, so it's also going to be like a festival-type atmosphere. But let me say something else about Team Snow Valley real quickly. They do more than just race. They also go out into the community. They teach kids about bike safety. So coming up in our next hour, we're going to hold our own Fox 5 Morning News bike clinic so that whether you ride your bike for racing or for fun, you have the information you need to know in order to ride safely, which is the most important of all. So back to you guys.
All right, Holly, thanks. He's got his helmet there. Just speaking of safety.
Yeah, we'll have that in our next hour.
Team Snow Valley is gearing up for its third annual Bethesda Grand Prix. It's going on this weekend. So we're learning all about the sport of bike racing. And did you know that bicycling is the second most popular sport in the world, second only to soccer? Soccer's a popular way to get in shape. As I catch my breath here, Arch.
That's right. And in fact, that's why we wear the heart rate monitors. And as you can see on yours, you're at about 123 beats a minute, which that's a really good training zone for you. So keep it up another hour.
All right, just another hour. We'll have more training tips and more safety tips coming up later on Fox 5 Morning News. So stay with us. Well, Brian, this weekend, 400 to 500 cyclists are going to be in Bethesda, including some Olympic riders. They're going to be here competing. They're all going to be competing in the third annual Team Snow Valley Bicycling Bethesda Grand Prix. It's going on this weekend. Man, these guys know how to ride, they know how to train, and they know safety. So with that in mind, coming up next, we're going to have our own bicycle safety clinic, including the proper way to fit and wear your helmet. It's all coming up next on Fox 5 Morning News. So stay with us.
This is a wonderful time of year, though, to get out and ride a bike, changing the subject. But there are things to do to help ensure that ride is a safe one. Our Holly Morris is in Bethesda, Maryland this morning with members of the Team Snow Valley Cycling Organization who have important safety information for us. Holly?
Well, Brian, Team Snow Valley is not only one of the top amateur racing teams in the U.S., but in 1996, 97, and 98, they were voted Club of the Year by the U.S. Cycling Federation. And one reason for that is because their mission is not only to race, but it is to get out the information to young kids about how important it is to be safe when you're out bicycling. So we're going to have a good old-fashioned bicycle clinic here this morning, courtesy of Team Snow Valley. Arch McCallan is the president and the director of the race, and he's riding in the race, and he does it all. So you're going to start it off, and we cannot talk about bike safety without talking about, first and foremost, our helmets.
Absolutely. Wearing a helmet is the most important piece of equipment. And we have got this nice bell helmet here, which I want to have you try on, Holly.
Okay. Believe it or not, people can put these on wrong, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And like the way you have it is the way most people wear them, which is way too far back. Exactly. Because it's not protecting the front of your head. So you want it to go on over the crown of your head like that, and then clip it on. And as far as like the tightness, you want to have just enough room to get about one finger underneath there. Any more, it would be too tight, but any more looser, and the problem is once you fall off the bike, a lot of times your head hits more than once on the pavement, and if it's too loose, it'll knock free, and then, you know, your head will be exposed.
So it's not enough to just put that helmet on. You need to have it be the right size, and you need to make sure that you wear it correctly.
Absolutely.
All right, we'll keep that in mind. Josh Frick is here. He's an elite rider, and we're going to talk about keeping our bike itself safe and the things we need to check before we hit the road.
Yeah,
so take me through
it. As important as the helmet is, your first goal is not to fall off the bike. And there's a number of checks you can do before you leave to make sure your bike's going to be safe. The first thing you should do is the tires, even though they're butyl and they don't leak air that quickly, over a period of even a week, it can lose half its pressure. And without correctly pumped tires, you could slide out in a turn or you're more prone to puncture. So you want to make sure your tires are really hard. You want to make sure you've tightened your brakes and that the brakes are depressing on the surface of the rim. If you're going to be riding at night, it's very important to have reflectors on the back and even a light on the front, not only so that you can see where you're going, but so that traffic can see you.
Important things to keep in mind, and you definitely want to take the time to check your bike out because it definitely could keep you safe on your ride. Kim Bonacorso is here with me. She's also another elite rider, and we're going to talk a little bit about road rules.
Exactly. You want to make sure that you follow all traffic laws. The same laws that apply to cars apply to bicyclists.
Mm-hmm.
The most important thing is to be sure that you're visible to your fellow motorists. You want to make sure that you know the hand signals, which are right turn, this is stopping and left turn. And you do it with your left hand so that the motorist can see you signaling, because you're always riding on the right side of the road.
And you hope that the motorists also know these signals. That's the other part.
Exactly.
Right? If you're a driver out there, you need to know what the biker's signals are so that you can respect what they're doing.
They're the signals are the same that apply to cars, mm-hmm. and that's actually on your driving test. So everyone should know that.
Right.
Everyone with a driver's license should know that.
Very good point. And Wally Bixby is here with me, and he's going to talk real quickly about what we should take with us if we're heading out for a bike ride. We've got less than a minute, Wally, so take me through it.
Some of the things you want to take so you don't get stuck out somewhere on a ride. You want to make sure that first you bring water so that you can stay hydrated. If it's hot out, you don't want to get too dehydrated, because that could be trouble trying to get back. You also want to make sure that you bring a tube and a pump, so that in case you do get a flat tire, you can change your tire so you can get back to your thing, and you can have a frame pump here. You also want to bring a multi-tool that can help you change any kind of problems you may have, and you can carry these in a seat bag that you have here.
So it's important not to just head out. I mean, you really need to think about your trip. You also might want to take, he said, 35 cents in case you need to make a phone call, or we suggested your cell phone. Believe it or not, Wally Bixby doesn't have a cell phone. We're still talking to him about that. Jump into the year 2000, Wally.
I'm trying.
All right. Hey, listen, you can see all of the riders, though, this weekend as they take part in the Snow Valley Bethesda Grand Prix of Cycling. It is the third year for it. It promises to be an exciting day, a full day of racing from 9 a.m. until 4:30 p.m. in the Woodmont area of Bethesda. It is co-sponsored by Fox 5. Our own Mike Lannis will be out here, and he will be the official starter for the last two races of the day, which are the elite riders. So that promises to be an exciting race where you can see the best of the best take to the roadways in our area. More importantly, though, we hope maybe we've inspired you to not only come out and enjoy the event, but to maybe inspire your family to get out and bike together, because it can be a great bike sport for the family. It can be fun, but you want to make sure you stay safe in the process. We got more coming up on Fox 5 Morning News after the break, so stay with us. We're going to ride off into the sunset. How about that?
By while most of us took it easy today, these folks shunned cool air conditioning for hot laps. We'll take you there coming up. If you want to have a pro-am bicycle race in weather like this, you better get a bottled water company as a primary sponsor. That's exactly what they did in downtown Bethesda today with the third annual Snow Valley Bethesda Grand Prix of Cycling. The final two races of the day included the senior women's pro-am, won by Joanne Kisanowski of New Zealand. And a little later, I got to start the senior men's pro-am, another very exciting race, won by Olympic silver medalist Brian Walton of Vancouver.
It was flashy dads. Pevlin Pops and other elite and amateur cyclists turned a 1 kilometer section of Norfolk and Rugby Avenues into a virtual velodrome as they whizzed their way to over $10,000 in prize money in the first annual Snow Valley Bethesda Grand Prix of Cycling. But while some dads were burning up the road, the race for affection on this special day was probably won not by fast cycles or fancy chassis, but by classic dads who have steered many of us along life's rocky roads.
Watching NBC4, working for you. Live from the area's leading news station, this is News 4 at 11.
Lots of folks tried to escape the sizzling heat, heading to swimming pools or just trying to find some place in the shade. But there were some folks who not only braved the heat, they tackled it. There were some bikers who competed today in a 30-mile race in Bethesda.
It's going to get hotter than this for me. Shouldn't be out here. Very, very hot.
Actually, your lungs feel like they're only half full. It's really hard to breathe.
I think we're crazy.